are going to discuss antifungal drugs. So let's start with the first antifungal drugs. So first drugs we are going to talk about is polyenes. Polyenes matlab kya hai? Enes we used to study when you used to study in our chemistry, right? Organic chemistry if you remember. Okay, kya kya tha? Kya kya tha usme? Ethylene, then ethene. Ye sab tha na? You remember still those things? Anyone?
Yes, sir.
Please tell me, I forgot. It's been, I think, I did my class 12 in 2008-2009. I forgot everything. Please tell me if you remember.
Propene, 3-carbon compound.
Propene. No, you tell the formula first. Jo pehle hota hai na, the name of the name of the group. Something is there.
Alkene.
Alkene. Alkene. Then alkene. Right? Then alkyne. I think. Correct?
Sir.
Okay.
Yes,
so
sir.
This is double bond, right? So alkene. So yes. We have here polyenes. Polyenes means, poly means many. Right? Many double bonds. Okay? So polyenes ka matlab hai many double bonds. So what are the example of polyenes? We have got amphotericin B. Okay? Then we have got nystatin and we have got hemisin. Okay? But these three drugs are very toxic. Very toxic. Okay? That's why I've written here amphotericin B is toxic. Okay? But nystatin and hemisin are more toxic. Hence, they are used locally. इसको कभी हम orally use नहीं करते हैं या IV use नहीं करते हैं. Okay? This nystatin and hemisin, we don't use it IV or orally. Even amphotericin B, we don't use it orally. No oral use. Okay? We use it only IV, IV infusion. ठीक है? And in severe, जब कुछ severe problem होगा, severe problem or severe fungal infections. Okay? Fine. So let's go to the next slide. What is the mechanism of action? It binds to ergosterol, creates spores leading to death of fungus, which makes them fungicidal. So most of the antifungal drugs are fungicidal, but amphotericin B and this polyene group are fungicidal. So how they kill? ये सिर्फ पढ़ने से नहीं होगा. Just I read it from here. It won't do. I have to understand what happens actually. What is this ergosterol? What is this creating pore? So human में क्या होता है? We have cholesterol, right? So fungus have got ergosterol. ये सोचो एक fungus है, ठीक है? This is the ergosterol, okay, in the cell membrane, okay. So what does amphotericin B do? It binds here, it binds here, okay. So dono yahan pe bind karne ke baad what happens? This moves apart and creates a pore here, okay. Ye isko is taraf leke jata hai, ye isko is taraf leke jata hai, and there is a gap here. And what happened? All the important structures present here, ribosomes and other things which are present inside the fungi, it comes out and leads to the death of the fungi. Okay? So this is the mechanism of action of polyenes. It binds to ergosterol, bind karta hai ergosterol, creates pore. This is the pore, okay, leading to all the important structures, they come out through the pore, which leads to the death of the fungus. That's why it is fungicidal. Okay, most antifungal are static, but amphotericin B and other polyenes are fungicidal. Okay? Okay? Next, we'll talk about amphotericin B a little bit. Used for serious fungal infection. We don't use this for small things, okay? small fungal infections. We use it for serious fungal infection. Okay, serious fungal infection. It is the drug of choice for cryptococcal meningitis or mucormycosis. Now mucormycosis आप लोगों ने सुना है, कोविड पेशेंट्स आर गेटिंग म्यूकोरमाइकोसिस, राइट?
यस
सर. सो व्हाट इज द ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर म्यूकोरमाइकोसिस? अगर म्यूकोरमाइकोसिस हुआ पेशेंट को पोस्ट कोविड, तो व्हाट वी विल गिव? एम्फोटेरिसिन बी. ओके, ओके. इट इज गिवन इंट्रावेनस. रिमेंबर व्हाई इट इज गिवन इंट्रावेनस, बिकॉज एम्फोटेरिसिन बी इज very toxic, and that's why we don't give it orally. Okay, we give it IV. Dene ke baad bhi, after giving IV also there are some problems related to that. Okay, even IV there is transfusion related problems, right? IV denge to IV dene ko kya bolte, transfusion, right? So there are transfusion related problems. Okay, so used for serious fungal infection, amphotericin B. Drug of choice for cryptococcal meningitis, mucormycosis, is given IV. Then it is very toxic, side effect hai iska, infusion related reaction. So kya hota hai, what are the infusion related reaction? It causes chills and fever. After you take amphotericin B IV, आपको क्या हो सकता है? There can be chills and fever. Like you take what they say, COVID ka you take vaccination, people get fever, right? Most of my friends and family members who have got COVID vaccination, they told me that immediately there is some fever. So similarly, when someone is taking amphotericin B IV, then there is chills and fever. Okay, then the next thing, it is nephrotoxic. Nephrotoxic means it harms the kidney. And kya karta hai kidney mein? It causes RTA. RTA matlab kya hai? Road traffic accident, is it? Can anyone tell me? What does RTA means? Anyone? None, right? RTA means renal tubular acidosis. We will study in medicine later. Okay? So renal tubular acidosis with hypokalemia. You have to remember hypokalemia. Okay? It causes renal tubular acidosis with hypokalemia. This is an MCQ. Okay, you will find it later when we will discuss MCQ. So this is the nephrotoxic. Is the most common dose dependent side effect. Most common side effect is infusion related, but dose dependent. According to the dose, that is nephrotoxic. Nephrotoxic. Okay. Then amphotericin B also causes bone marrow suppression. Okay, bone marrow suppression hone se kya hoga? Anemia and other such symptoms. Okay, so this was about amphotericin B. Now amphotericin B has lots of problems, right? So we need to find a solution better than amphotericin B. Then the people came out with something known as the liposomal amphotericin B. Amphotericin B, socho, this is the amphotericin B, and then liposomal amphotericin B is covered. Okay, so that when it touches the kidney, it does not harm. Amphotericin B alone, it goes to the kidney and it attacks it. Okay, and leads to the renal tubular acidosis. But this one is protected, liposomal amphotericin B, so that it does not harm the kidney. Okay, but there is disadvantage of liposomal and amphotericin B also. We'll talk. This is less nephrotoxic as compared to conventional amphotericin B. So this is less liposomal for L for लेस नेफ्रोटॉक्सिक, ठीक है, लेस नेफ्रोटॉक्सिक देन, बट कॉस्ट इज हायर. हाँ, बट कॉस्ट इज हायर, दिस इज द डिसएडवांटेज ऑफ लाइपोसोमल एम्फोट्रेसिन बी, दैट कॉस्ट इज हायर. ओके, द कॉस्ट इज हायर, इट इज लेस नेफ्रोटॉक्सिक बट कॉस्ट इज हायर. ओके, देन इट इज द ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर कालाजार. कालाजार विच इज द ऑर्गेनिज्म विच कॉजेस कालाजार, एनीवन?
लेशमेनिया.
वेरी गुड, वेरी गुड, वेरी गुड. लेशमेनिया, लेशमेनिया कॉजेस कालाजार, एंड लाइपोसोमल एम्फोट्रेसिन बी इज द ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर कालाजार. रिमेंबर दिस, दिस इज एन एमसीक्यू क्वेश्चन. ओके, देन दिस निस्टैटिन, वेयर डू यू यूज निस्टैटिन? हमने बात किया पोलीइन, राइट, we talked amphotericin B. Now रह गया निस्टैटिन एंड हेमाइसिन. ओके, तो निस्टैटिन इज यूज फॉर ओरोफेरिंजियल कैंडिडियासिस, ठीक है, एंड हेमाइसिन इज यूज टॉपिकली फॉर फंगल इन्फेक्शन. ओके, नाउ वी विल टॉक अबाउट एलाइल अमीन्स. एलाइल अमीन्स क्या है? एलाइल अमीन्स, सो वट इज एलाइल अमीन्स? एलाइल अमीन्स इनिवेट SQ for sequalene, not jacqueline, okay, sequalene epoxidase, okay, and lead to accumulation of sequalene which is toxic to fungal cell. So allyl amines are fungicidal drugs, and there we have got azole, inhibit alpha 4 dimethylase. So ye hum just reading won't do, we need to understand in detail. So this ergosterol, how is it formed? Sequalene है, sequalene is converted to lanosterol by the enzyme sequalene epoxidase. Okay, and this lanosterol is converted to ergosterol by the enzyme 14 alpha dimethylase. Okay, and when this sequalene to lanosterol is inhibited, the drugs which inhibit this conversion of sequalene to lanosterol, they are known as allyl amines. Okay, fine. And the drugs which inhibit lanosterol to ergosterol, these are known as azoles. Okay, inhibit 14 alpha dimethylase. So these allyl amines are fungicidal in nature. Okay, but this azole are fungistatic. Why? Q, because this sequalene, when this conversion is stopped, sequalene to lanosterol is inhibited, this sequalene gets incorporated, okay, in the within the fungi. Okay, so this sequalene gets incorporated, or what is the term exactly they use? Just a minute, if I could remember. वहाँ पे रह जाता है, मतलब it accumulates. You can say it accumulates there. Okay, and sequalene is fungicidal. Okay, this causes fungicidal effect. Okay. But lanosterol is not like that. Lanosterol, it accumulates. If it accumulates, no fungicidal effect is seen. Okay, so you have to remember from here. What you have to remember? You have to remember this conversion: sequalene to lanosterol, lanosterol to ergosterol, sequalene to lanosterol by sequalene epoxidase, and lanosterol to ergosterol by 14 alpha dimethylase. I know these are very tough names to remember. Even if you understand, I know you will understand definitely, because I am explaining it so simply, but still you will have difficulty memorizing this. So please take your copy, practice the names 10 to 15 times, then you will be able to memorize it. Okay, so sequalene, allyl amines inhibit sequalene epoxidase, and azole inhibit 14 alpha dimethylase. Okay, what are the example of allyl amines? Terbinafine, butenafine, naphtenafine. Terbinafine, have you heard or anyone have used? I think boys must have used. जो fungal infection होता है ना, पैरों में हो जाता है sometimes. Tinea capitis, tinea pedis, any tinea this wrestlers में होता है, उसको क्या कहते हैं? Then tinea ungium in the fingers. There are many types of tinea. Okay, so allyl amines are fungicidal and available in oral form as well as topical preparation. So allyl amines are available in oral form as well as topical. Okay, so example kya hai, you remember all the fine, everything is fine with allyl amine. Okay, allyl amine ke sath sab kuch fine hai. So terbinafine, butenafine and naftifine. Okay, after absorption these drugs accumulate. Even if you give it orally, kya hota hai, after you give this drugs orally, it goes to the blood, right? Blood ke baad jaane se kya hota hai, you have given orally, it should go to the other structures of the body, right? But it never goes anywhere, it goes to the keratin rich structures areas. Okay, after absorption these drugs accumulate in keratin rich areas. Like where does keratin is present? Skin, hairs and nails. Okay, so keratin rich jahan pe keratin hota hai wahan pe this terbinafine or allyl amine groups chala jata hai, and that's why therefore these drugs are useful in fungal infection of skin, nail and hair. Skin, nail or hair ka infection ko kya kehte hai, that is known as dermatophytosis. Okay, dermatophytosis. Okay, this is tinea infection. We will study more about this tinea infection in microbiology. Okay, I have posted many videos of mycology. Mycology matlab a study of fungi. Okay, in my YouTube channel, in our YouTube channel actually, in our YouTube channel you can go through it. Okay, microbiology, I have around 23 videos on bacteriology, virology and parasitology, plus 3 videos on mycology. So second year, please go through them, and the NEET aspirants, NEET MDS aspirants, you can definitely go through them. Okay, there are 26 videos, almost all the syllabus is covered, little bit is left, few things are left which I'll cover in our live classes. Okay, so now next, azoles. Okay, azoles are fungistatic. Azoles are fungistatic. Okay, so azole ka example kya hai, ketoconazole, fluconazole, itraconazole, voriconazole and posaconazole. Okay, so this ketoconazole has some problems, that's why we don't use it regularly. What is the problem? First thing is it causes gynecomastia. You know gynecomastia? What are the drugs causing gynecomastia? Anyone can tell me? Anyone? Drugs causing gynecomastia? The disco drugs. Okay, the disco drugs. DI for digital is, S for spironolactone, C for cisplatin. Then digitalis kahan pe use hota hai? In cardiology we use. Spironolactone is a diuretic, if I am not mistaken. Yeah, it is a diuretic. Cisplatin, I have to remember this. Ketoconazole, antifungal drug. Okay, and estrogen is used, this is in endocrinology we use. Okay, so drug causing gynecomastia are digitalis, disco yaad rakho, DI digitalis, S for spironolactone, C for cisplatin, K for ketoconazole and O for estrogen. Okay, ketoconazole is not much in use these days. Why? Due to microsomal enzyme inhibition. It has lot of drug interaction. Iska matlab kya hai? It interact with drugs, different drugs, and causes many side effects. Okay, that's why it is not generally used. Then it causes gynecomastia, humne baat kiya. Then it causes adrenal suppression and it is also hepatotoxic. Okay, then fluconazole is commonly used. Ketoconazole nahi use karte hai hum, but we use fluconazole. Okay, so maximum oral bioavailability is with fluconazole. Maximum CNS penetration is with fluconazole. दिस इज द ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर कैंडिडा एंड क्रिप्टोकोकस. ओके, तो याद रखो दिस इंटर्न्स, आपको कैंडिडियासिस पेशेंट मिलता है तो आपको मैम पूछेगी व्हाट इज द ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस, यू शुड से फ्लुकोनाजोल. ओके, ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर कैंडिडा इज फ्लुकोनाजोल. ओके, एंड फॉर क्रिप्टोकोकस मेंटेनेंस फेस में हम फ्लुकोनाजोल यूज करते हैं. बट इफ समवन सेज क्रिप्टोकोकल मेनिंजाइटिस, तो क्रिप्टोकोकल मेनिंजाइटिस इज ए सीवियर इन्फेक्शन, राइट? मेनिंजाइटिस इज ए सीवियर इन्फेक्शन. देन इन सीवियर इन्फेक्शन व्हाट डू वी यूज, we use amphotericin B. Yes, you are right. Amphotericin B. Acute phase, amphotericin B. Okay. Now itraconazole. Itraconazole. Okay. Itraconazole कहाँ पे use होता है? Histoplasma, histoplasmosis, sporotrix जैसा sporotrix infections and blastomycosis. Okay. So how we can remember? HSBC याद है? HSBC, what is HSBC? You know anyone? What is HSBC? What is HDFC?
The
banks. Okay, HSBC. So you remember HSBC. So HSB. Okay, HSB. Okay, or you remember his B. Okay, or you can remember his B. Any way you can remember, or HSB. Okay, this I, when we say HSB, some I portion is coming, right, phonetically. So you histo I ko waha pe use kar lo, that it is itraconazole. Okay, so you remember HSBC, itraconazole. Okay, yeah, HSB. Okay, HSB. Okay. Then voriconazole. Voriconazole कहाँ पे use होता है? Aspergillosis. This is more about memorizing. Drug of choice for aspergillosis. Okay. Then posaconazole is used for mucormycosis. But in mucormycosis, what is the drug of choice? It is amphotericin B. But posaconazole is the only azole working in mucormycosis. So they may ask you, only azole working in mucormycosis, what is it? It is posaconazole. Okay, remember this. Then we have got next is heterocyclic benzofuran drugs. Okay, so example is grisofulbin. Okay, so how does it act? It does not act on ergosterol. Okay, it does not act on ergosterol. It acts on mitotic spindle, that is the DNA. Okay, it is an oral anesthetic drug. It has high affinity for keratin, is used for dermatophysis and avoided in patient taking alcohol due to disulfiram reaction. Okay, you know disulfiram reaction? Anyone can tell me disulfiram reaction?
Withdrawal symptoms.
No. Anyone else? If you take alcohol and then you take any of those drugs like grisofulbin, so kya hoga? There will be some symptoms after which, like, you cannot drive a vehicle because there will be some nausea. Some symptoms will be there which will cause you some reaction. Jiske karan you cannot act normally. Okay, there are some symptoms which will cause you to behave abnormally. Okay, you cannot be normal at that time. Like alcoholic, with alcohol disulfiram reaction is there. Okay, I think I'm mistaken here. I have to check it out again. Okay, anyway, please check it out. Please forgive me for the mistake if I'm mistaken. As far as I remember, this is it. I'd like to check again. Okay, then five, flucytosine. It inhibit DNA polymerase. Okay, cryptococcal meningitis में use करते हैं along with amphotericin B. 5-flucytosine कहाँ पे use करते हैं? In cryptococcal meningitis along with amphotericin B. Okay, then there is echinocandins. Echinocandins में I really know, friends, कि ये सब वेरी टफ नेम. आई एम गोइंग वेरी फास्ट, बट यू हैव टू रिमेम्बर द नेम्स. बाय प्रैक्टिस ओनली यू कैन यू वुड बी एबल टू रिमेम्बर द नेम्स. सो प्लीज, इट्स नॉट डिफिकल्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस थिंग्स. यू जस्ट हैव टू मेमोराइज सम मैकेनिज्म ऑफ एक्शन एंड द यूजेस, बट द नेम्स इट्स रियली टफ. यू हैव टू प्रैक्टिस अ लॉट. ओके, तो इकाइनोकेंडेंस में आता है कैस्पोफंजिन. ओके, कैस्पोफंजिन, तो इसके नाम में ही इसका आंसर है, यूजेस है. कैस्पो, सी ए कैंडिडा. ओके, एंड ए एस पी एस्परजिलोसिस. ओके फाइन, तो कैस्पोफंजिन एक्ट ऑन β13 ग्लाइकन ऑफ सेल वॉल. न्यू ड्रग्स आर देयर, माइकाफंजिन एंड एनी डूला फंजिन. ओके, then there is another drug known as tavaborol. Okay, this acts by inhibiting fungal tRNA synthesis. It acts on protein synthesis, and it is used in dermatophytosis. Okay, now we will discuss some previous year question, NEET question, AIIMS question, आपका जिपमर question, then you have got क्या बोलते हैं, PGI चंडीगढ़ questions. Okay, तो first question. A diabetic patient presents with fungal infection of sinuses and periorbital region with significant visual impairment. The best drug for treatment of this patient is, first you identify what is the
A.
disease.
Leukomycosis.
A. Okay, they were disease A. Who was that?
Leukomycosis.
Yes, you are right. Mucormycosis. The answer is A, amphotericin B. Very good. Then, amphotericin B causes deficiency of
Calcium.
calcium.
Calcium. Calcium.
No,
Calcium.
no.
Calcium. Potassium.
Yeah,
See.
potassium. Potassium. You forgot, I told you hypokalemia. You remember I told you hypokalemia. What does hypokalemia means? Yeah,
Potassium.
deficiency of potassium. Okay, this is an MCQ question. Okay, you remember whatever I teach, all are MCQ questions. Okay, I don't teach just, I don't just take it from book and just present it to you. I do heavy research before I present something to you. So those things which are which I present here in all the classes, please do take them seriously. Okay, amphotericin B toxicity can be reduced by. How we can reduce amphotericin B toxicity?
A.
A.
Incorporating ribosomal complex.
Yes, liposomal complex. So what are the problems with amphotericin B? Please tell me.
Nephrotoxicity.
Nephrotoxicity. And then anyone else?
Bone marrow suppression.
Bone marrow suppression. Very good. And something.
Causes chills and fever.
Yes, IV infusion related problems. Okay, chills and fever. Okay, voriconazole is not effective against. It's not
B
effective. B, yes, you are
B
right. Mucormycosis में क्या यूज करते हैं हम? Amphotericin B. We don't use voriconazole. Voriconazole is not used in mucormycosis. Okay, then which drug would treat both dermatophytosis and candidal infection? Dermatophytosis के कौन ट्रीट करेगा? You remember I told you the group? It is
एलाइलमाइन एलाइलमाइन
एलाइलमाइन. नहीं. Please fast. We have very less time. 3 minutes left. I have to finish five more questions. It is ketoconazole. Okay, ketoconazole.
किसकी
Ketoconazole. देखो, ketoconazole is the first orally effective broad spectrum antifungal drug used in both dermatophysis and deep mycosis. This is a line from your book KD Tripathi. Okay. योर बुक के डी त्रिपाठी में लिखा है कि कीटोकोनाजोल कैन बी यूज्ड इन डर्माटोफाइसिस एंड कैंडिडल इन्फेक्शन. ओके, तो Liposomal amphotericin B has the following advantage over conventional amphotericin B. What is it?
Lesser nephrotoxicity.
Yes, very good, very good. Lesser nephrotoxicity.
Yeah.
Which of the following is not an antifungal drug? Bata? Which one? Which is not antifungal? You please do research on these drugs. Okay, I will tell you the answer. This clofazimine is an anti-leprosy drug. Okay, we will study clofazimine when we study leprosy. Okay, anti-leprosy drug. Okay, next. Which of the following is caused by amphotericin B? Please tell. Yes, very good, very good, very good. Hypokalemia. Okay, the antimicrobial agent which inhibits the ergosterol biosynthesis. Remember,
B.
Inhibit.
B.
Inhibit. No, you are wrong. This amphotericin B binds, binding.
A. A.
A. Yes. A. A.
A.
Inhibit the ergosterol biosynthesis. Amphotericin B, B for binding. Okay, you remember, binds to ergosterol. Okay. The last question. Which of the following is treatment of choice for cryptococcal meningitis?
Amphotericin B.
Yes, amphotericin B. And what we can use along with amphotericin B?
Fluconazole.
Fluconazole. Before what? I told you some slide back. Just a minute. This is, yes. So cryptococcal meningitis may, along with amphotericin B, 5-fluocytosine is used. Okay.